صلوات الله وسلامه على نبينا المصطفى، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلوات الله وسلامه عليه تسليما كثيرا. The Prophet mentions sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the min ashrat as-sa'a an yataqarab zaman, from the signs of the hours that time is going to fly by. So here we are in 2022, in the first khutbah of 2022. And I'm going to acknowledge 2022 of the Gregorian calendar, because we live in here and this is the reality of our lives. But you should know that that Gregorian calendar, as we said many times from this minbar, it was introduced by Pope Gregory, one of the leaders of Christianity. And that whole calendar is shirk and kufr, polytheism, paganism. When I give dawah to my relatives, I try not to be disrespectful, but the reality is my relatives are pagans, celebrating Christmas, Easter. What they believe in has nothing to do with Isa ibn Maryam. And I don't mean that in a disrespectful way, because there are Muslims from amongst us who also, we have paganism mixed up in our Islam, going overboard with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and sheikhs and khurafat, hocus pocus. 2022. So what is the first khutbah of 22 going to be like? 2022, inshallah. I remind you of the statement of the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, أَوَلَمْ يَرَوْا أَنَّا نَأْتِ الْأَرْضِ نَنْقُصُهَا مِنْ أَطْرَافِهَا. Do they not see how Allah has taken the earth and the boundaries of the earth and he caused them to shrink? So the round earth that we live on, it's massive. It has boundaries. It has atraf. Allah said in this ayat, he causes those boundaries and the corners of the earth, he causes it to shrink. One of the interpretations of that is that the scholars of Al-Islam, they die. And when the scholars of Al-Islam die, we are in trouble because we are not scholars. So since the last 2 years, COVID started 2019, and it really hit the map in January, 2 years ago. It's the second year of COVID. For the most part, we had a lot of ulama that I've checked out and they have died. Rahmatullah alayhim. Ulama of the sunnah, ulama who are guiding lights and guiding posts for the people of our community. And from them is my Sheikh, Sheikh Abu al-Harith Ali al-Halabi. Rahmatullah alayhi. And other than him, people will call into the sunnah and give him fatawa based upon dalil. And when the waves of adversity and fitin come, they're the ones who stand up strong, not apologizing, not acquiescing, not trying to please people from their followers or the kuffar or other than that. They say what it is. So while these scholars are dying, rahmatullah alayhim, as a result of COVID and other than that, we have other scholars who are talking, other du'at, while the ones who are dying who know the deen and the sunnah and tawheed and issues like that, while they're dying, we get the ashab al-khurafat, those people who every single year they don't miss the opportunity to make the dajjah in the world about the permissibility of saying Merry Christmas to Christians. The deen of Islam doesn't allow you to believe for 1 second that Christmas can be merry or that you can say that to somebody. But they come out every year. One of the oldest learning institutions in Islam is Al-Azhar. And there is Khair in Al-Azhar. And there are ulama in Al-Azhar. And there is a sunnah with some people in Al-Azhar. But the mufti every year makes it his point. And this is not against the mufti of Al-Azhar. Ghafar Allahu lahu wa lana. Lana wa lahu. It's not against him. I'm making a point. The people who their religion is hocus pocus and making istighatha and asking other than Allah, like some of these leading Sufis of our ummah, Al-Habib Ali Jafri, millions of followers are following these people. Every year they come out and telling our kids who we're trying to make jihad to get them to understand, you are Muslim. Lakum deenakum waliyaddeen. It's part of your identity in Islam. These people come and they say, no, you have to be progressive. You can't be rough. You can't be tough. You have to be politically correct. If white people don't like it, it's a problem. Europeans don't like it, it's a problem. So we're going to say, no, Islam has hikmah. Allah is al-Hakim. And his Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam knew how to deal with people. So I want to stand here before this community. And I want to say here at GLM, the first khutbah and the topic for 2022, Ummat al-Islam. Those of you who love the Nabi of Islam, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and his brothers from the prophets and the messengers, salawatullah wa salamu alayhim ajma'in, is the importance of al-wala wal-bara. Al-wala wal-bara. You are not a real Muslim if you don't know and understand, comprehend, and practice al-wala wal-bara. So those of you who want to see an ayat from the ayat and the sunnah of Allah Azza wa Jal, you get you some tea, you put you some sugar in that tea or whatever, honey, whatever. That hot ball in tea, that water, when you put that sugar in there, brown, white, honey, it's going to yadhub. It's going to melt. And it's going to be just like the surroundings of that cup that's inside of that cup. Same thing's going to happen, not just to our children. It's going to happen to you and I. If we don't know something about this issue, that in order to be a Muslim, you have to stand up and say, Lakum dinukum waliyadin. So in this masjid, we had about 60 people embraced al-Islam in the last year. May Allah give them thabat. 60. They're listening now. They're here now. You can't just become a Muslim and then you just want to, you know, tip around and everything is okay. You know, you have to let people around you know. You have your way of living and I have my mind. What I worship, what I believe is unique, it's distinct. How I dress, how I eat, how I behave, how I exist is special, it's different. And there are many things that parallel in our lives, but there are many differences between you and I. So as it relates to the issue of al-wala wal-bara, the Nabi of Islam, he told us, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لا يتوارث أهل ملتين شتى. It is not allowed for people who have different religions to inherit from each other. So my mother, my father, they have money. One of them dies, may Allah guide them to Islam before they check out. One of them dies, my uncle, my aunt, my brothers, my sisters. If any of them die in other than Islam, I can't inherit from them. They can't inherit from me. Although Islam said, Sidat Rahm, your mother, your mother, your mother, then your father. All of those are hadith about connection, your ties of relationship. Al-Islam is a religion of hikmah, justice. And yet Allah Azza wa Jalla said, you can't inherit from them, they can't inherit from you. Why? Al-wala wal-bara. It's not because Allah isn't merciful and Allah doesn't acknowledge in the religion the special position between family members. Allah Ta'ala has revealed a number of ayat of the Quran that leave no doubt. Bring some of them to your attention. Allah Azza wa Jalla mentioned in the Quran, إِنَّمَا وَلِيُّكُمُ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Ya Muslim, your wali, your friend, your protector, the one who you take as a friend, the one who you take as a protector, الولي, the awliya, it is Allah and the messenger of Allah and those who believe. They are your awliya in the deen of Islam. So we have this ongoing issue of our shabab not understanding what's a friend in Islam and who's a friend. So he hangs out with gang members who are now Muslims, who make tasji and encourage him to kill his brother Muslim because he comes from another part of the city, or because they bumped into each other on Coventry Road. So they pull out a knife and kill a man, kill a boy in front of everybody. And the Muslim boy doesn't know. Al-wala wa bara prevents this from happening, inshallah. So our awliya are the Muslims. So right now, our children are growing up. Since 1986, becoming a Muslim, I've seen the problem of Palestine. I got to stand with them. Al-Iraq, Kashmir. I've seen the problem of Syria. I see the problem now over there in China, the Uyghurs. As a Muslim, we're always passionate. We're always standing with them. Why? Al-wala wal-bara. They're our brothers. And I can't fail to mention right now the apartheid racist state of India that goes under the radar all the time. and the atrocities that they're meeting out against people for saying La ilaha illallah, and the world says nothing. And you don't know about it. The racism, the extremism, people losing their lives, getting raped, and we don't even hear about it. So the point here is, we're going to stand with and behind our brothers. But that doesn't take away from the fact that when oppression goes on in the world, I'm an African American. What they did last January 6th, it shows and it proves what America is about. But my wallah's with the Muslims first and foremost. But as an African American, I'm against racism, oppression, double standards, hypocrisy. So we stand with the Muslims first and foremost. Even if the Muslim's family is not Muslims and they go against him, he stands with the Muslims first and foremost. Allah mentioned in the Quran, one of the many ayat, La tajidu qawman yu'minuna billahi wal yawm al-akhir yuwaduna man haddallaha wa rasulahu walau kanu aba'ahum aw abna'ahum aw ikhwanahum aw ashiratahum ulaika kataba fi qulubihim al-iman wa ayyadahum. You will never find a person who really believes in Allah on the last day. You will never find him being a bosom buddy and a friend and giving love to people who wage war against Allah and his messenger. Even if that person happens to be his father, his son, his brother from his tribe. That's our religion. لا يتخذ المؤمنون الكافرين أولياء من دون المؤمنين. وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْ ذَٰلِكَ فَلَيْسَ مِنَ اللَّهِ فِي شَيْءٍ إِلَّا أَنْ تَتَّقُوا مِنْهُ تُقَاتْ وَيُحَذِّرُكُمُ اللَّهُ نَفْسَهُ وَلَلَّهِ الْمَصِيرُ. From those many ayat, it's like La ilaha illallah. There's a negation. There's no God worthy of worship. And then you establish except Allah. These are how these ayat come. These ayats come and they make negation. That al-wala wal-bara is with Allah, is messaging the believers. Only, it affirms that. And then negates that it's with other people. You will not find a people who take as bosom buddies and protectors those who wage war against this religion. And he thinks that's light? Listen to the other ayah. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu. La tattakhidhu alladhina attakhadhu dinakum huzuwan wa la'iba min alladhina utul kitaba min qablikum wal kuffara awliya. Oh, you believe. Don't take those people who look at your religion as a joke, fun and play and jesting about your religion, from those people who were given the book before you, and before from those people who are disbelievers. They're awliya one to another. Do not take them as your friends, your bosom buddies and your friends. Allah said, whoever does that, he's from them. And Allah is warning you himself. Allah is warning you himself that this is a serious issue. So as a Muslim, and as Muslims, we look and we dress differently. From how we look is that our wives wear the niqab. Our wives wear the burqa. Someone of responsibility in this country has the nerve to say that the Muslim woman in her burqa looks like the letterbox. He would have never said that if it had something to do with the Jewish community, because it's insensitive. It's racist. It's not acceptable. And we always sensitive and worried about being politically correct. And these people say anything about our religion. So my wife looks like a letterbox. I'm offended by that. It would never be said about any other group. And then the ayah said, don't take those people as your awliya when they play around with your religion. That is lib about your religion. So we have many, many ayat in the book of Allah Azza wa Jal, Ummat al-Islam. Al-wala wal-bara. No. La ilaha illallah automatically makes it wajib for you to disconnect yourself from shirk and from the mushrikeen. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa nas'alullah at-tawfiq wa sadad. Alhamdulillahi wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah. Does that mean that Islam is against community cohesion? Does that mean al-wala bara, al-wal bara, al-wala wal bara, that Islam doesn't celebrate, appreciate, and acknowledge diversity that exists between us? No. Al-wala wal bara is something, and these issues about giving dawah with hikmah is something else. Al-mu'amala with these something else. For those 60 brothers and sisters who accepted Islam, we told you over the days of Christmas and these holidays, don't be like this and don't be like that. Don't be like some of the brothers and the sisters who we knew when they accepted Islam, they were rough with their parents. Don't be like that. And to conclude, there's a surah in the Quran, Al-Mumtahina, to test them. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, idha ja'akum al-mu'minat muhajiratin, famtahinuhunna, Allahu a'lamu bi-imanihin. فَإِنْ عَلِمْتُمُهُنَّ مُؤْمِنَاتٍ فَلَا تَرْجِعُهُنَّ إِلَى الْكُفَّارِ لَا هُنَّ حِلُّ لَهُمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحِلُّونَ لَهُنَّ. Oh, you believe, during the time of Mecca, if believing women come to you, Ya Muhammad, Abu Bakr, Umar, in the community, they want to be protected, they come to you, test them to see about, are they really Muslims? Allah knows the reality of the iman. If you find that they are really Muslims, do not send them back to the kuffar. Those Muslim women are not halal for those kuffar, and those kuffar are not halal for the Muslim woman. So as soon as she becomes a Muslim, one of the 60 of those people, the masjid becomes the wali of that girl. Her father, no, the masjid becomes her wali. Al-wala wal-bara. So during that time, Surah Al-Mumtahina, Abu Bakr, he had a wife. Her name was Qatila. Qatila, the murderer. She used to kill, that was her name. Bint Abdul Uzza, she hated Islam. Like some people, our relatives, other people, hated Islam. But she wasn't antagonistic. She just hated Islam and that her daughter Asma became a Muslim. She came to visit Asma bearing gifts, loving her daughter like our non-Muslim relatives love us and we love them. Bearing gifts, I brought you a gift. The mother said, or Asma said, I'm not accepting the gift. Stay there, I have to go and see. I have to ask about it. So if you don't know, do what Allah told you to do. Fas'alu ahla dhikr. Ask those who know. Don't make ijtihad in this stuff. Christmas gifts and all of this stuff. Ask people. Don't just make ijtihad and do it. Hold up. Let me come back. Her and her sister, Aisha, they went. Rasulullah was shocked. Your mother came bearing gifts, came to visit you. He knows her condition. He said, connect your mother. That's what we do in our religion. We have al-wala wal-bara, but that's my mother gave birth to me. It's my father and my brothers, my sisters, my relatives. And then Allah revealed the ayat in Surah Al-Mumtahina. The ayat said, لَا يَنْهَاكُمُ اللَّهُ عَنَ الَّذِينَ لَمْ يُقَاتِلُوكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ وَلَمْ يُخْرِجُوكُمْ مِنْ دِيَارِكُمْ أَنْ تَبَرُّوهُمْ وَتُقْسِتُوا إِلَيْهِمْ. Ya Ummat al-Islam, those people don't fight you because of your deen. They don't make fun of you and give you problems. They don't expel you. They are not making us trouble. Allah doesn't prohibit you from dealing fairly, justly, and kindly with them. But we understand from that hadith, that ayat, but if they fight you for your deen and they mess around with you, it's not from hikmah from you to be bosom buddy. What bosom buddy? People are fighting us. So if you have the ability, you push that negative energy comparable to what's coming to you within the boundaries of the deen. As for everything is cool, we all, no, it's not cool. So we're in a country that allows us to practice our religion. But don't get it twisted for 1 minute. That doesn't mean games are not being played. We ask Allah to accept it from us, to accept it from you. In this upcoming Gregorian calendar of 2022, we ask Allah to give us long life, prosperity, longevity, and protect our children, our mothers and fathers, and that He make strong those reverse who embrace Islam, and let them be doors and windows and examples for those people who are behind them to embrace this religion. Aqim as-salat, yarhamakumullah.